Still a bit warm here in Florida, but really all things considered, a wonderful fall afternoon for football here in Tampa at Raymond James Stadium. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Chicago Bears. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Seaman, and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down. This one off to Jones. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Third play here. This opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Here's Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Brady now on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And a nice pick up there. He gets about five down to the 4-yard line.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, we're looking at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
Yeah, they went with the elusive, slippery guy. Couldn't get in there, though. Montgomery able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one. Now, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is... And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. David Montgomery, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bears are on the board first here on the road in Tampa. Santos with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Here's Bernard. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Now they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski. And he's taken down inside the 30. 16 more on that one and another first down. And, Charles, this defense, they know that they've got their work cut out for them. Here's a quarterback coming off a game in which he threw four touchdowns. And they've watched the tape all week. They've seen it. But what can they do differently?
I think they've got to approach it like a pitcher facing a really hot batter. Get him uncomfortable in the box. Change speeds, change locations, change the pitches you throw at him. So show different coverages, blitz sometimes, drop back other times. Just don't let him get comfortable or let him get into rhythm.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy. And that's what they're doing early in this game.
And he stopped immediately there. Now that was a textbook example of how to be aggressive at the point of attack.
Yeah, make sure you take care of the line of scrimmage. No way they can get upfield on that one. And then how about the force he brought on that tackle? Let them know they need to be aggressive from this point on.
Brady to throw on third and one. escaping the pressure right. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down. And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They'll run. This is Bernard. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. A solid pickup of five and a very solid fourth down conversion. And defensively, pure frustration. They'll run it here with Bernard. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight. Now a carry for Bernard. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. No doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they? But they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
Steps away, and he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Jason Pierre-Paul able to get him down behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of a yard. The sack cost him only a yard. It's second and 11. Another try after the first down sack. Fields, he's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Give him 9 on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Bucks with an extra defender now in the secondary here on third down. To throw is Fields. Now the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And he will have the Bears first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on third and 3. Fields to the veteran Robinson for the Chicago first. On first down, it's Fields. Flush to his right. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Check 26. Back.
his shotgun handoff to Cohen. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Out of the gun, Fields. Man open is Robinson. The 30, the 20. And finally he is out of bounds, but not before taking it down near the 15. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Week 7 action, and we've got a 7-point game here in the second quarter. And this offense hoping to change that right here. A give to Cohen. He heads right. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. To the ground, this time Montgomery. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. David Montgomery with his 2nd TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Bears go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points. Santos now to add the PAT. It's good to make it 14-0. Now, after the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And 2 picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects him.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw 4 or 5 picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. The give is to Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35. After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. To throw, it's Brady. Flushed out right. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise, and start to put together some drives.
And he's got this down to the 35. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And they move this all the way down to the 9. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Brady gonna throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. The intended target was Chris Godwin, but it'll be second and goal.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. To throw is Brady. They're targeting Godwin once more, this time complete. That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal. Extra point up and good by Suckum. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
To the right side, and he's got more complete. There he goes, right side.
I'm the best in the game. I'm the best in the game.
And he does take it in for the touchdown, but a flag on the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
So the illegal forward pass also costs him a down, and now it's second and long. Off play action, Fields. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down. The Bears on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be third and 15. Throw, Fields. And the throw there going to be incomplete. Good coverage there by Carlton Davis.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On second and 10, Brady. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Artie Burns, former first rounder, there to break that one up. The Bucs on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross-state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 40. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play too.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide, because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 33. And they will finally put an end to the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around the defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Here's Fields. And they're going to get it. They bring it down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Interested to see what they dial up here. Third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Fields looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Montgomery. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good, and they will open things up a bit more. It's 24-7. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And with a 3-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. And
is caught. It's Chris Godwin. And he's brought down after a very nice game. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. From midfield, here's Brady. And now here's another interception. Picked off at the 22. That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all of these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
He's going to loft one deep over the middle. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now it's Fields. Throw left side complete. That's Robinson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's second and 2 now from the 3. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Santos' kick is up and through. And that will do it for this first half. So we reach halftime with the visiting Bears out on top here. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it. But I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Here's Fields. The throw fighting its target, the tight end Horstead. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. First target, first catch, and a first down.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
Now a first down throw. Fields forced out to his left. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Another 6-yard carry, same as last play. First down. They run. This is Cohen. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Second and 5 now. Fields. And he checks this one down to Williams. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1-yard pickup there on second.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
On third down, they go Montgomery. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring up a 4th down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front, and a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
They snap it to Fields. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it. And this return's going to go backwards about 8 yards, but the interception is good, and they have the football. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they just got a little help from their defense forcing the turnover. Now can they make that payoff in points?
They need to, partner. They're down on the scoreboard. Need to take advantage of those opportunities, and this is a good one right in front of them.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards. Brady now on first down. And he's got Gronkowski yet again. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Now Brady. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Artie Burns, former first rounder, there to break that one up.
You get the sense that they're saying we're not playing up to what we're capable of and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Brady looking middle, and it's incomplete. It was Sheldrick Redwine with good coverage that time as he was there to knock it away.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
Eluding the pressure right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, They brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr. The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. That one goes for 24 yards. Now Brady. Looking for Brown, and he's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Antonio Brown, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six. Extra point put through by Suckup, and that cuts this lead down to 13. The touchdown now. It's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Couple yards dropped at the 17. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And last time was a pretty one play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. 43 yards rushing for him now in the ball game. Working with a second and four. Play action. It's Fields. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here comes the Bears punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Yards that time on the punt, and out will come the offense as they take over. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now.
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Yeah, he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That'll give him 60 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Airing this one out for Evans. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Mike Evans with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Buccaneers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Extra point up and good by Succa. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chili on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. If there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained. So they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. And he rifles one incomplete. Darnell Mooney, the target there. But now it'll be third down.
And now offensively, it's third and 10. And I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. That'll put him at 96 yards receiving now for the game, and he's got a first down as well. Fields throwing again. And he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, but frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. One play action, Fields. But the man is Kmet, the tight end. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 31-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Out of the gun, running with Cohen. 50 yards on the ground for him so far.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. Now a run with Montgomery. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Fields now to throw. They'll roll him out right. Oh, no, he lost the football. And this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well.
Can almost see inside his face mask there the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around the lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture.
Third down, it's Montgomery, and he'll only get this to the 17, well shy of what he needed. Give him 3 yards there, as that'll take us to fourth down.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And that will make this a 9-point lead. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now, as you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down 2 scores. You don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself,
oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucs have made this a 1-score game.
No, we're not cheering. No, we're not rooting. But I am excited about this. I know you are, too. We got a ball game again after that big-time strike.
Big-time strike, and you are right. Don't go anywhere yet. This thing's not done. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit, and you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Second and 9. Fields. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. They call his number again. It's his 6th catch and a first down.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Dancing to his left. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
Down, here's the run with Montgomery. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up second and 7. Now it's Fields off the bootleg, sliding out of the pocket. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Handoff, it's Cohen, and he'll go down to the ground at the 39, and obviously that's well short of the first. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Here comes the Bears punter now as he's on to kick it away. As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turn it over there, that's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last
time.
That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for Chicago, it may not be too late to salvage their season as the win moves them to 2-5 now on the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the San Francisco 49ers. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, the loss drops them back to 4-3 so far. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in New Orleans against the Saints. I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.